Hey, what's up, guys? We are out here. This is my dad. This is Roscoe, my pops. This is a big day for me. This is the first time he has ever been air gun hunting. Now, we're out here at the Mountain Meadow Hunting Preserve at the Lethal Airs first ever premier big boar hunt, and it's exciting. Number one, Roscoe. First time he's ever been air gun hunting. Number two, had rotator cuff surgery 6 weeks ago. He's using the hammer, so it's a little different than the average air gun. So if he shoots something and then he falls over, we'll just see what happens. I'm excited. You ready for this?
I'm ready.
You excited?
I can't wait.
So this is it. First father-son air gun hunt right here on camera, an American Air Gunner.
It's your turn. I've taken you hunting. Now you're taking me hunting.
Roscoe, we got an opportunity. We're going ram hunting. We're looking for rams.
Rams.
Big old
yep.
honking rams.
That's right.
It's snowing. We're going to be on foot. We're gonna spot and stalk. You look good in that prime one too. I mean, we're in the wrong pattern because it's snowing, but I mean, it still looks good and we're warm.
Yeah.
Here we go. All right, so Roscoe.
Yeah.
Dialed in at 50 yards.
Okay.
You're gonna be about 6 to 8 inches low at 100.
6 to 8 inches low at 100.
It's gonna, you'll wanna aim high.
I understand.
It will shoot up there.
At 50 yards though, I can just aim
just
straight.
Put it right on them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who's gonna tell me it's 50 yards?
I will, I've got my range finder.
Anticipating coming out here and hunting, you know, I've been watching your show obviously for a number of years and not knowing anything about what it was gonna be like. And I gotta tell you, it was nothing like what I expected. It was about 35 degrees, a little chilly. We didn't hunt in blinds, which is what I usually do. So we just got out of the ATVs and started walking, looking for animals.
This was great though. Got my dad out. First time we've actually been able to go air gun hunting. You know, we get here last night, everything seems fine. We wake up this morning, it's snowing. Literally, it's snowing. Now, just to give you guys an idea of what I'm talking about here, when we woke up this morning, it was snowing. If you look behind me, there's no snow on the ground. Like, we were out in the woods for like 8 hours chasing these rams.
Well, there were a few hogs running around here and there, and we were gonna pass on those for now.
We jumped up on some pigs. They were bedded down. We saw them a little bit late, so they got to jump on us. So the snow's turning to rain. We're to hunt, rain or shine.
And then we found a herd of rams, about seven to ten of them, I guess.
Yep, I see it.
Kind of stalked him a little bit.
I got a shot at that brown one. Yep.
Found him, got him, got ready, and got a good shot.
Okay, if you got a shot, take it.
Things are ramping up in West Virginia, but we'll be back to wrap up that hunt a little later. First, let's take a close look at the Adamant M2 from Russia with love. American Air Gunner is sponsored by Umarex Airguns Zeroed In, by Pyramid Air, the world's largest retailer of air guns, and by Prime One Camo. Be the Predator. We're back in West Virginia. So my dad Roscoe and I have been tracking a herd of rams all morning, and we have finally caught up to them and found a good vantage point.
I got a shot at that brown one. Yep.
Found them, got them, got ready, and got a good shot.
Okay, if you got a shot, take it.
And missed, and was disgusted, needless to say.
He just pulled. We were shooting straight uphill, and he just didn't compensate for that, and he shot, and we saw it just hit low. He just hit below the animal.
And let me tell you, the terrain up here is unbelievable. Up and down hills, and it was muddy. And, you know, we're covered in mud.
If they'll stay there, we could walk up that road.
Yeah. Let's start there.
Caught up to him again. Waited for a good shot.
Right about 60 yards.
60?
60
or so. Okay, here we go.
Missed.
He ends up pulling when he got that shot again and missed again. He got pretty bummed out. My dad's always been, you know, like me. He's an athlete. He does things really well. He's good at a lot of stuff. So to shoot and miss, you know, it's not his thing. He wasn't stoked about it.
That herd's moving. They're not moving real fast. We still got the weathers on our side.
Yeah.
So let's just keep doing what we're doing, because we're getting on them. We're getting shots.
Okay.
And just when we get that shot, just remember, take your time, get settled in, get lean, get something, and then.
Got it.
Okay.
But again, the herd of rams, you know, ran a ways, and we just kind of waited them out. Came across them, and we anticipated where they were going to go, and so we kind of went around the mountain and kind of got up on a little ridge, and lo and behold, they came by about 50, 60 yards away, and as they went down a trail, made their turn, I took a shot.
Yeah, hit. He's hit, watch him, he's hit. That one. Roscoe,
man, this has been a hunt, buddy.
So we tracked it for, gosh, I don't know how far.
I'm gonna end up down there.
And it's just not fun. And we finally get up that hill. We see a bunch of rams, and they kind of scatter as we kind of crest the hill, and then we see the one just laying there.
And there he is.
Ah, Roscoe. Oh man, you did it. You did it.
I'm excited,
Roscoe. So let's talk about it. How's your shoulder, first of all?
My shoulder's sore, but well worth it.
Talk about this hunt. Struggled early, right?
Well, it started out, you know, like, oh, let's go shoot a ram. Well, yeah. 10 hours later.
I mean, it snowed on us this morning. It's rained on us. We've been in and out of this mud.
Oh, my gosh. Walking up and down these hills has just been, it's been tiring, but, you know, the thrill of the hunt is always overshadows the tired.
Yeah.
Always.
Well, I know you're disappointed a little earlier. Kind of had a couple shots that you got away from your.
Well, you know, I got the shoulder, and I was trying to be a little bit careful with it. So I probably pulled off those first couple I shot at and missed.
Yeah.
This time, I was bound and determined.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not going back to Arkansas without a ram.
No, you are not. So this is by far the most difficult, challenging,
you know,
fun. Right, I mean, this is a hunt. Like, we've always sat in a blind.
When I hunt in Arkansas, I crawl up in a blind, sit there, one comes by, shoot it, kill it, throw it in the four-wheeler, drag it in.
Yeah.
If I had a Fitbit on right now, yeah, it would have exploded an hour ago.
67 years old and just getting it done.
Absolutely.
You look exhausted.
I'm tired.
Roscoe, I love you, man.
I love you.
This has been fun. I'm glad you could make this trip, and I don't think this is going to be our last one.
The experience was unbelievable. The hunt was unbelievable. Hunting with Rossi was the greatest thing in the world. You know, I'm worn out. I'll sleep really good tonight, I'm sure. All in all, I'd say it was very, very successful. It was really a challenge, but I got to tell you, it was more fun than anything I've ever done. I enjoyed it. I can't wait to come back.
And he got a nice little ram. He's going to mount it. He's got a great rack. And then we just had an incredible hunt. And we had one day to do it. We got it done. It was an awesome, awesome hunt.
But the hunt's not over. Remember those pigs that we saw earlier? Well, some of them were huge. And I just happened to bring that Adamant M2 357 on the trip. So when we return, I'm going back out there to see if I can get myself a hog. American Airgunner is sponsored in part by Air Venturi, the power of air.
We came out here to the Lethal Air premiere air gun hunting weekend, and it was just such a great weekend. I mean, the lodging's amazing. As you can see behind me, I mean, just the atmosphere up here, and like it's absolutely beautiful. And so now I'm kind of in a situation like, now what do I do? I know my dad's done because he's exhausted and his knees hurt and his shoulder. So I'm gonna go pig hunting because I saw some big pigs today, and I've got an Adamant the M2 357. So I'm going after wild hog. With this 357, I'm gonna try to ear hole something, and so we can both come back with two good animals and some good food. We're gonna make it happen. I'm just gonna go out. I'm gonna go back where we were. I know there's some solid hogs out there. There's still a solid couple hours of daylight left. It's gonna be rainy and misty and foggy, and I'm gonna get back up in the woods and I'm gonna get after it like I wanted to. I'm pretty sure my dad. Roscoe, you good? You wanna, Dad? No, okay. All right, I'm gonna take that as a no. All right, I got my Adamant M2 357. I'm gonna go find me a big old hog. I'm gonna ear hole it, and I'm gonna be eating up some sausage next weekend.
I'm more or less going back to the area where we know these hogs like to hang out. I'm just gonna walk up and down some hills, keep my eyes and ears open, and hope the weather cooperates.
It stops snowing, but it's like there's light rain. The wind is blowing towards us. Those pigs that we jumped up earlier came up over this ridge and then went down into this ravine, and we saw a big group of them, and they kind of laid back down. So I'm going to work my way through here because the weather is on my side. It's snowy, everything's wet, it's kind of quiet. And about 300 yards down this hill is, these pigs are just kind of like laid in. So I think if I come up over the top, I should get a shot on one, maybe just kind of laid down, because in this kind of weather, that's what they want to do. So I've got the Adamant M2 357 Polymag Predators, right? So these things, so they're kind of a hollow point. They got this little tip. When they go in, it all kind of breaks apart, and my goal is to just get up close on top of something, sneak up on it, get a shot in the ear hole, put it down.
So I'm just walking over this ridge, and I don't see a herd of pigs, but I do see one, and it's one of the biggest pigs I have ever seen. And thanks to the light dusting of the snow, I was able to sneak up on him and get as close as needed with the Adamant M2 357.
He's hurt. I'm gonna reload. That is a big old pig. That's where I shot him. When you came down, I put that second one in him. He jumped up and just took off down here and just laid here, right here. It's bleeding out. There's blood everywhere down there. I caught him right in the ear. The cutters in this thing are crazy. Come on. Bleeding like crazy. Oh man, that's a big old boy. Now there's a problem. He's stuck down in a trench and I got hit with a tree on top of his head. Help! It's been a snowy, rainy weekend. Had an incredible hunt with my dad doing the ram. I came out and tried to do a little hog hunt with the old 357. I gotta get this thing out and see what it looks like, but there you go. That's it. That's it. We got him. If you're gonna go hog hunting, it's a good gun, but like you gotta get up close, and I'm talking like you gotta be very precise. Like you're not getting this thing into a pig side. There ain't no way.
You guys didn't really think I was gonna drag this out by hand, did you?
Whoa. All right, so there you go. You guys got a chance to see. This is a big hog. You know, 357. This is a gun. If you're gonna go hunting something like this with, I mean, you'd rather go for thin-skinned animals. But if you're gonna go for like a hog with something like this, you have to hit their brain. Their brain's about this big. So it's all about, you know, accuracy, getting on top of it, getting a good shot, getting nice and close. But that is it for this hog hunt. There is no doubt this is by far the biggest hog. I wish I could get a weight on this thing before, because we're gonna gut it out here, but I wish I could get a weight before, because It's like, right? It's got to be in the 300s, right? Let's call it 380. No? Whatever. They don't care. They're just like, will you stop talking so we can get this thing out of here? All right. How quick can bacon come out of this and into my mouth? From here?
All right. So last night ended up being too dark by the time we got back and got settled to do this interview and talk about this pig hunt. But what an unbelievable pig hunt. I'm so glad that I went out last night and got that done. And I was determined to sneak up on one because I was using that Adamant, you know, M2 357. So I had to get close, get an earshot, and I wanted a big old pig. So I finally saw this big old dude. A bunch of pigs ran. They all kind of laid down, and there was a big monster in that group. So came up over this ridge, literally got in within about 20 yards, and just popped one right in his ear. Finally, got in, got the right shot, put it on, and that thing just went down. And awesome hunt, biggest pig by far I've ever gotten. And can't wait to get some of that meat. And of course, donate a bunch of that meat to Hunters of the Hungry, which is great. So it's gonna feed a bunch of folks here in the Virginia and West Virginia area. The Lethal Air Big Boar Hunt was an absolutely successful weekend.
You've been watching American Air Gunner, the only televised show all about air guns. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and subscribe at AmericanAirGunner.com. Now engage your brain and go shoot an air gun.